Good morning, students. In the previous videos, we started with areas of parallelogram. Okay. Now let's do a quick recap of what we studied till now. Now, when we started with the areas of parallelogram, we found that the area of a parallelogram is base into height. Yeah. Now, after that, we also found that when two parallelograms are on the same base and between same parallels, the areas are equal. After that, a triangle and a parallelogram sharing same base, and if they are between the same parallel, the area of a triangle will be half of area of parallelogram. And based on that, we have done few problems as well. Now let's continue with 11.2 where we stop. Now the third question. P and Q are any two points lying on the sides of DC and AD respectively of a parallelogram ABCD. Show that APB is equal to area BQC. So they are talking about a triangle ABCD. Okay. Now there is one point here. They are telling that P and Q, P lies on DC, P lies on DC and Q lies on AB. Now in this, we have to prove that area of a triangle APB is equal to area of a triangle BQC. This is what we have to prove. Now how do we prove that? Now in this, first thing, take parallelogram ABCD and triangle APB. So can I write triangle APB is equal to half area ABCD? Why? Because common base AB and they are between same parallel AB and DC. That is the first equation. Now the second equation, BC is the common base and they are between same parallel AD and BC. Can I write area BQC is equal to half of area ABCD? Why? Because common base is BC and they are between parallels AD and BC. Now this will become the equation number 2. If you compare both the equation, on the right hand side we have this common. So comparing equation 1 and 2, we get area APB is equal to area BQC. This is how we prove. Now the next one. In the figure, P is a point in the interior of a parallelogram. Show that area APB plus area PCD is equal to half of area ABCD. Okay, now the rest of the problems I will explain you, but I want you to give a try. Let me draw the diagram first. ABC. Now the point is here. This is P. Now what are they asking? APB, this area plus this area PCD, half of ABCD. What we can do here is draw a line like this. Okay? Now this is a parallelogram. Same base between same parallels. So the area of ABCD is equal to half of ABEF. Equation number one. Next, BC same. This is remain same parallel. So I can write PDC is equal to half of area this one. When you add both the equation, you will get area of this triangle. Area of this triangle will be equal to half of both this triangle. So when I get both this triangle, it is nothing but the complete ABC. Okay, that is how you solve the first question. The second one is area of APB plus area of PBC is equal to area of APB plus area of PCD. Now, in the first case, we have already solved the area of APB plus area of PCD is equal to half of area ABCD. This we have already solved. Done. Next, draw a line like this. Okay? If you draw a line like this, you will still see one triangle here and same base. And we see another triangle here, same base. So you will end up with APD. Area APD plus area BPC is equal to half of area ABC. Now again, if you compare these two equations, this is common. If this is common, so these two will be equal. This is how we do the second part. Okay, two questions I have asked. I want you to give a try. Now the fifth question. Okay, let's do this. Now in the fifth question, PQRS and ABRS are parallelograms. X is any point on side BR. Now I have a parallelogram like this. Then, and there is one more parallelogram. Yes. PQRS I have to prove area of PQRS is equal to area of ABRS. See, these two parallelograms, they are already on the same base and they are between same parallels. Therefore, both these areas are equal. So you just have to write a statement here. They are on same base SR and between PB and SR. First is done. Now the second one, triangle AXS. Okay, here I have AXS. Area AXS is equal to half of PQRS. Area AXS is half of PQRS. This is what we have to do. Now we already know these two are equal. Now look at AXS. See in which base this is lying. This is lying on this one. So I can write area AXS is half of ABRS. Is this correct? Now I know this ABRS is equal to PQRS. So I can just replace that. It is nothing but half of PQRS. This is how we do the problem. Now friends, until unless you don't practice by yourself, you may not understand perfectly. So I want you to practice. See, whenever you see the video, I want you to write down. Do not just see the video. Write it and then see, it will be better. And you will understand it better. Okay? I want you to try all these problems. And if you have any doubts, any clarification, this will be sorted out in your interactive session. Thank you, students.